This is a little speaker that was given away as a prize if you bought two large cans of Pringles around 2013 or 2014, I don't remember exactly. This is the actual speaker. Some information there. And to give it better amplification, you put it on a small Pringles can like this. And I also made some holes there. I don't remember where I read that recommendation, but those holes have been there for years. And it plugs in with a 3.5mm jack, which for most people ain't even okay these days because they don't have this type of jack on their phone. It's a cheap little thing, but it sounded okay for tests. It's powered by three AAA batteries, and because I don't use this very often, I don't keep any batteries in it. However, the last time I used this was a few months ago, and I left the batteries on it, and then time passed more quickly than I thought. Today I went to check back on it, and there's a surprise. Battery acid. And yes, you're not supposed to keep batteries on a device you don't use for a long time, but I didn't know that 4 or 5 months would be that long. And also, these are original Duracell batteries. Just because they're popular doesn't mean they're the highest quality, but I'd think their quality would be sufficient, so if this can happen to them, it can happen to pretty much any battery like this. So let's take a look at what happened. Obviously, one of the battery corroded the contacts, and the switch was set to off, of course. There used to be a black metal grill over the speaker, but I removed it, so you can see the bare speaker right there with a plastic cone. So one of the batteries, the one that has the most corrosion, expired in March 2019, which is over 2 years ago. But they were still holding a charge, which is why I was still using them. Guess I won't be using them anymore. Let's try to take them out carefully. And yeah, that battery contact is gone. So I don't know if I'm gonna be able to fix this little speaker. I'll try, but yeah, this is pretty bad damage. And the other battery expires in March 2026, and that one still seems to be okay. The contacts don't seem corroded. And how about that test to check if they're empty or not? Well, it bounces quite a bit, but it doesn't mean that it's empty. Maybe it's half capacity or something. One of the 2019 batteries here, this contact looks fine, and so does this one. This one is the one that wreaked havoc inside the speaker. Although the positive contact of it is fine. There are three more screws, so let's try taking it apart and see what's inside. I think this job calls for my little Phillips screwdriver. Oh, the screws are actually already loose. I've never taken this speaker apart before, though. And there's what's inside. The speaker is pretty thin. In fact, it doesn't have a lot of bass. The electronics over here are pretty simple. I don't know much about this type of electronics. The little chip there seems to have some marking, but it's so small I can't read it. No, this camera doesn't focus that close. Looks like it says LM4821, but it's so small that I'm not sure. I have to take a photo of it and zoom in on it. It looks pretty dusty inside. Obviously, this thing is not waterproof or dustproof. But not much we can do from here. Maybe we can take a look at the speaker. Oh, I thought it said KFC. It says KEC. And it's 6 ohms, 1 watt. Well, what can I do about those battery contacts? They are beyond repair, I think. This thing is just coming off. Although there's still a little bit of the spring in there. Maybe I should try cleaning it off with alcohol. But I doubt it's gonna work again. I'll see what I can do and then I'll show you what I've tried. I just realized that ring that fell off the battery contact is not actually from the battery spring. The spring is still in one piece, but it's from the isolation thing on the battery. So that thing came off the battery, not the battery contact of the speaker. And the reason why one of the screws was loose is because this little stock was broken off one of the screw holes. I don't know how that happened, but that's why. The other two screw stocks are fine. Well, after cleaning up the contacts, they don't look that bad. There's still some corrosion behind them, but they aren't as corroded as I thought. I thought they would fall apart and be totally unusable. But this doesn't mean the contacts are still good. So let's try putting on the two batteries that weren't corroded. And I'll add a new battery here. Don't worry, I will take all three of them out after doing the video. And I also cut my nails. Well, look at that. I didn't say anything because I didn't want to jinx it, but after cleaning up the contacts and turning it on, the LED lights up. So let's close this. I'm not going to bother screwing on the battery cover because, as I said, I will remove the batteries soon. Put this on and try playing some music on my phone that is considered an old, obsolete piece of junk, but it has this thing your new phone does not have. And I can unlock it without looking at it or removing my face mask. I have some royalty-free music here. Let's try playing it. And it works fine. So let's see if we can hear the difference in sound with the can and without it. I didn't screw the speaker shut because I didn't know it was gonna work, but it just fell apart again. I intend to fix the little stock here that broke off. Just need to put some super glue on it. But for now, I'll just use the two stocks that aren't broken. It should hold the speaker together well enough. When screwing things back in, especially on plastic, you should always slowly screw counterclockwise. And when you hear the click, immediately stop and start screwing it. Because if you don't do that, it will not align the screw to the plastic thread and it will rip the plastic. So after just a couple of screwing and unscrewing, the thread for the screw will not be there and the screw will not hold anything and just fall out. And you don't have to screw too tight on plastic. Anyway, let's resume the test. So hopefully you can hear, even through this video, that it does make a significant difference when you have this little amplifying thing. So that's it about this little Pringle speaker that I managed to save barely. Before I forget, I'm going to remove the batteries. One of them just fell on the floor. And store the speaker like this when I'm not using it. So there we go.
I cleaned up the last bits of corrosion using some more alcohol and an old toothbrush. Now it almost looks brand new.
So while I was editing the video here, and yes, I've started to use Kden Live instead of iMovie, I wanted to take a closer look at the batteries. This is the one that leaked battery acid. It is a Duracell, and it says original equipment accessory. So it must have been included with some device. Of course, I don't remember what. It was Best Buy March 2019. And over here it has some marking that says August 2012. So that must be when this battery is from. And this one is totally gone. It's unusable. I have to throw it away. I'll look up the proper way to dispose of this. As you can see, it has the do not throw in the trash symbol. And it says made in China. This one, also expiring in March 2019, has some different marking. First, it doesn't say original equipment accessory, so I thought it would have been bundled together with the other one, but probably wasn't because it has different markings. And it says made in Belgium. And as we saw when we tested the speaker, even though it's a bit rough around the edges, it does still work. And this is the other one, best before March 2026. This one was also made in Belgium. And it's still good too. The other 2019 one didn't say when it was made. And just for comparison, there's the other one. Came Lion. Made in China, but it's fine for now. I mean, made in China is not synonymous for bad quality, but who knows? I'm not so sure about this one. I don't think it's a fake Duracell. I mean, it could be, but it doesn't seem worse build quality than the other two, or even this one. Thank you for watching. Gotta remember to put these away, otherwise I'll lose them and I'll never fix the speaker properly. Actually, why do I have to think about a hiding spot for these little parts when I've got an empty can here? Perfect.